Hi everyone. There's a lot of myth related to alopecia areata, which is a hair disorder. So today I chose to speak on this topic. A lot of people don't know what exactly alopecia areata is. Alopecia areata is a common autoimmune skin disorder causing patchy hair loss on the scalp, beard, eyebrow, eyelashes, or any other part of the body. Alopecia areata is an autoimmune disorder. An autoimmune disorder is one in which body's immune system incorrectly attacks the body's own cells, which in case of alopecia areata is the hair follicles. Usually the bald patches appear suddenly and affect only a limited area. Risk factors include genetics. Particularly when the disease occurs in people younger than 30 years of age, there is usually at least one family member who's affected with the similar disorder. The risk of developing alopecia areata is also unusually high in people who are suffering from some other autoimmune disease like thyroid, vitiligo, pernicious anemia, and Down syndrome. Stress can also be another aggravating factor. This condition is generally symptomless. Sometimes you can start seeing the onset of this problem as small, round, coin-sized or oval patches of baldness appearing on the scalp. The area of bald skin looks smooth and normal with no itching, burning or redness. More severe forms of this disorder can have hair loss involving the entire scalp or even the entire body, including eyebrow, eyelashes and beard. The most common form of alopecia areata is patchy, in which there is one or more coin-sized hair loss patches on the scalp or other areas of the body. Alopecia totalis is another form in which there is complete hair loss from the scalp. The third form is alopecia universalis, which involves hair loss from the entire body, including scalp and face. Treatment of alopecia areata can vary depending on several factors, including the age of the patient, the amount of hair loss, the duration of hair loss, and the area affected. For limited areas of alopecia, the most effective initial therapy is a series of corticosteroid injections given into the bald patches to suppress the immune reaction. In rapidly progressing and widespread diseases, oral corticosteroids can be given. Topical treatments include topical application of steroids, immunomodulators, growth promoters, and counter irritants. If you or your loved ones are suffering from any of this symptom, then consult your dermatologist immediately. Stay happy, stay healthy.